So an expensive guitar, of course, will be much more delicate than just a cheap one. Why? Because same like if you pick, say, a $10 watch and throw it to the floor, or if you pick a Piaget or a very fine Cartier or something like that and throw it there, obviously the Cartier is less resistance than the $20 watch, right? So why? Because it's much more, that's why it's finer, because it's more delicate, also comes in the package to be a better watch. Then you have watch for resistance thing, that's another thing. But what I'm saying is that sometimes people do not take care properly of the humidity levels in an instrument. Like for example, we should have at least the simplest egrometer, like this one, which now is reading here. You see here 72% humidity. So we have a lot of 75, you see, 72. But this will oscillate up and down, move up and down. Even in 10, 20 minutes, we have to control humidity levels. If in other guitars we didn't do that, that's just totally irrelevant when it comes to instruments like these, which certainly is much better made and finer, and therefore is more delicate because of the materials as well, which are lighter materials. And by changing the fretboard from the obsolete ebony one to these ones, which are 100 times better to play for playability, then you have to also take care that this wood is not ebony. Therefore, you have to take care of humidity levels carefully. It will not happen anything, but you have to control that. Right? So it's just like monitoring your instrument, at least on a daily basis, to see if it needs humidification or not. This is very important because a guitar will be, if it's a great instrument or even a medium range one or even the basic model of it, like this 1932, it's an incredible instrument, but you have to take care of it. And then the fact that you mistreat other instruments or bad guitars, cheap guitars, or badly made or factory made, or even handmade but not very accurate instrument, and didn't happen anything by not putting humidity or not controlling. We are not used to do this. It's an austerity actually. It has to do a sacrifice and an effort to be, I have to control if the guitar has the proper humidity. So you do that with love and the instrument will react in another way, right? But if we transgress that rule there to take care of humidity levels, then this is a problem. And then of course this is our fault, not the brand's fault or anyone's fault. We have to take care of that. So this is true what you just said, that in fact sometimes cheap guitars are very resistant, but it's like if I have an uncomfortable pair of shoes because they last a lot, so and then what? But this is, it's not comfortable to wear, right? So the finer is an instrument or a jewel or anything, then it will be, you have to take care, it's maybe more fragile. So it's just to take care of the humidity and then it solves, everything is solved immediately. So that's how I have been, never have problems with this humidity. Very rarely, sometimes we forget to put 2 years ago one humidifier thing in the Terral, 45 hot here in the summer, so hot. And then that was a mistake. And then sometimes the guitars resist, sometimes it may not resist, it may crack, or even if it's finer wood, the finest wood, it will be also more delicate even. So you have to be careful. It's just that. Keep the guitar not close to a heater, for example, or put them in, going in the sauna room with it. You know, you have to be careful. This is a logic thing and a very simple process. Actually, it takes 2 minutes to do if you are willing to do it. And it fixes all the story right away. So that's what I recommend you to do, is control your humidity levels properly. I will post in the description of this video how to do that and how it moves up and down. Because I made many videos on this thing. People think this is an exaggeration. Or you tell, I generally say to everyone, use this thing, have one, put it, control that thing. Say, oh yeah, they don't take care of them. Oh wow, it cracked here. Then that's why. That's why I'm preventing you with the thing. It's just a logical thing. Just like clothing or how you say if it is in Toronto we have snow there in the winter probably sometimes 20 under zero, right? Freezing cold. Then you cannot go there naked or with this shirt, right? You have to go with appropriate clothes. So it's just a logic thing. And if you follow this just this very simple principle to take care of the humidity levels and take care of your instrument, it will last forever.